Hey everyone, I'm Ken Paris and I'm one of the product managers at Rocky Mountain Bicycles. It's been 4 years since we introduced our first e-mountain bike, the Altitude Powerplay. From the outset, our goal was to create an electric mountain bike that felt as natural as possible. To achieve this, we created the Dyname 3 drive system, a completely in-house design that delivered on that goal while providing industry-leading torque and power. Since then, we've grown the Powerplay lineup to include the Instinct and the Growler alongside the original Altitude. While we added new models to the Powerplay line, our R&D teams based out of St. George, Quebec and North Vancouver, British Columbia continued to look forward. With the input of riders from around the globe, we came up with four main design goals for the next iteration. We looked to simplify the design, make it user-friendly, increase the range, and reduce the weight while continuing to deliver that Rocky Mountain feel that we're known for. To achieve these goals, we designed an all-new drive system, the Dyname 4. Our motor is now smaller and lighter while maintaining the same torque as the previous generation. Additionally, we added brand new features like the Jumbotron, an integrated top tube display, and a removable battery to ease diagnostics and service for riders and mechanics. First off, at 108 Nm, the Dyname 4 motor is one of the most powerful motors on the market. Dyname 4 can produce impressive torque numbers, and it was important for us to have that power delivered in a natural way. Our solution was by producing an inline torque sensor. That sensor directly reads the tension of the chain and the power that you're putting through the pedals. This information is fed directly into the drive, achieving instantaneous response. There's no unwanted lag between your pedaling and the torque being applied. The amount of torque being delivered by the system is directly proportional to the effort that you're putting in. In conjunction with the torque arm, we've also designed a power curve within the bike's software to deliver that torque smoothly to the ground, allowing you to soft pedal around tight switchbacks or drop the hammer through a chunky, punchy portion of the trail without losing any grip. The Dyname 4 drive system is so intuitive that you can simply focus on the trail in front of you. But if you'd like to take that one step further, there's also the option to tune the power delivery to best suit your needs with two new adjustable parameters, boost level and power assistance. The boost level adjusts the torque sensitivity. This essentially adjusts how the motor responds to the input it feels on the pedals. A higher boost level requires you to put less pressure down on the pedals to deliver the same torque. A lower boost level will mean you have to put down more power in order to get the same maximum torque. The second adjustment is the output power. This is the percentage of available power that the Dyname 4 motor will put out in the different assist modes. There are four different modes that can be used to manage battery levels, to adjust your trail speed, and to fine-tune your effort levels. On top of the impressive power delivery, the Dyname 4 drive is also really quiet. That notorious whine of electric motor when pedaling is virtually non-existent with our new drive thanks to our internal gear ratios. We've also removed the upper slider that was seen on the previous generation to further reduce the noise created by our drive system. This gives you a bike that sounds like you're riding a bike and not an electrical appliance. Something that we heard regularly from Powerplay riders was the desire for a removable battery. Our 2022 platforms deliver on that as the new frame hosts an easily removable battery. There's no longer the need to drop the drive just to pull the battery out. Just simply remove the cover and battery retention bolt with a 4mm hex key and the battery slides right out of the frame. One of our goals with the new bike was also to increase the range. So for the new Powerplay, we've upped the battery size from a 672 watt-hour battery to a 720 watt-hour battery. A 720 watt-hour battery is a large battery, and with that, you'd expect there to be a long charge time. But the Powerplay is about riding and not sitting next to a power outlet. Our new 4-amp charger quickly refuels the battery from empty to a full charge in 3 hours and 55 minutes, encouraging you to get back out there. The 2-amp charger will charge the battery from 0 to 100% in 7.5 hours, which outpaces the competition. The second generation of Powerplay is also compatible with our Overtime Pack. This Overtime Pack stacks on an extra 330 watt-hours of battery life for a total of 1,050 watt-hours to explore with. Another feature being introduced to the Powerplay lineup is the top tube display we've affectionately named the Jumbotron. The Jumbotron displays key information like your speed, battery life, and optimal cadence prominently in front of you while maintaining the clutter-free cockpit that we strive for with the first generation Powerplay. The screens can be cycled through using the redesigned remote on the handlebar. This new remote is smaller than the one seen on our previous generation of Powerplay. It has three buttons that allow you to cycle through the screen and options on the Jumbotron. The Jumbotron is a simple-to-use interface when paired to the remote. The up and down buttons allow you to cycle through the different options in a menu, and the button marked with the lightning bolt is the select button. Hitting the lightning bolt button will allow you to cycle through the different information screens while riding. If you happen to go down during a ride and damage the remote, you can still adjust the modes using the on-off button on the Jumbotron, helping you finish your ride. Previously, we had a dealer app that was needed by the shop when servicing our Powerplay models. We've removed the need for that app by displaying the information on the Jumbotron itself. There's no more need for a laptop or phone when maintaining or riding the new Powerplay. With a new drive comes a new frame design. This new frame comes with a myriad of features that are shared between the analog versions of the Altitude Instinct that we released earlier this year. This includes highlights like high quality enduro bearings throughout the frame, with dual bearings used at the seat state to chain state pivots for increased durability and stiffness. We also have an interchangeable forward shock mount that allows you to customize your travel mount no matter which model you purchase. The frames also offer frame adjustments that will really allow you to dial in your bike for a personalized feel. Our rear axle flip chip allows you to adjust your chainstay lengths by 10 mils, longer for increased stability or shorter for increased playfulness. Like many of our other frames, we also use Ride 4 adjustment system, giving you four different options of geometry and kinematics to choose from. The Powerplay frames also feature a new mid-high main pivot that is closer to a drive cog on the motor. This results in higher anti-squat values, leading to more support and efficiency when pedaling. The mid-high pivot also gives the frame a more rearward axle path, which allows the rear wheel to move away from impacts more easily. This eats up those hard square edge impacts, giving the bike a more composed feeling out on the trail. For protection, both the Altitude and Instinct Powerplays feature a burly bash guard to help protect the frame, as well as the Dyname 4 drive system. Additionally, we have thick rubberized down tube protectors, a slim seat stay protector with a chain catcher, and a rib chainstay protector that effectively absorbs chain slap for a smooth, quiet ride. Carrying over from the previous generation of Powerplay frames is the use of a standard press-fit 89.5mm bottom bracket shell. Unlike other systems, the Dyname 4 motor does not contain the bottom bracket and cranks it on the drive, so there's no need to send the drive away when replacing your bottom bracket bearings. The new Powerplay will be available in two models, Altitude Powerplay and the Instinct Powerplay. The Altitude Powerplay has 160 mils of travel and looks to fulfill the Altitude's legacy as a leader amongst enduro bikes. Ready to handle the world's roughest and rowdiest trails, the Altitude Powerplay has a geometry that will keep the bike calm and composed in any conditions. Where the 160 mil Altitude Powerplay is built for charging, the 140 mil Instinct Powerplay is built for exploration. If you're looking to venture into the Alpine or explore a new zone, the Instinct Powerplay will offer an experience that will constantly have you searching out for new adventure. When you turn on your Powerplay for the first time, you'll be able to set the language preference, the units, and the screen brightness, and there will be an option to tune your assistant settings. When you first get on a Powerplay, we recommend playing around with the settings. Try out different modes, boost levels, and assist level. Try out the extreme, test out the high output, big boost settings to get a feel for the drive, and set up a low power, low battery use tune as well. This will give you three distinct ride feels, allowing you to fine tune your settings to best suit your ride style. And make sure that you read the manual. Thanks for taking the time to learn more about the new Powerplay and Dyname 4 drive system. If you'd like to learn more, head into your local dealer or visit our website, bikes.com.